Well, if you would prefer it, I could put you in with your friend Frankie. Outside. Just sit there, nice and quiet, until the police want to interview you.
Come in.
Find anything?
Nope. Was he popular?
Very. He helped a lot of the women here.
Well, he seems to have made one enemy. I don't think we're going to learn much from this lot. Take it out of the station, go through it there. Give us a ring if you find anything. Well, perhaps we can start by you telling me what you know.
Not much, I'm afraid. There was a riot. We followed the normal procedure, locked the security gates and waited for them to calm down. Unfortunately, a group of prisoners grabbed one of the officers and were holding her hostage. Bill went in to try to get her out.
As a psychologist, I wouldn't have thought that was his job.
The officer was his wife, Meg Jackson.
I see.
I've made a list of the group of prisoners. They were the only ones close enough to have stabbed Bill.
Thanks. There's more than a dozen names here. Still, it's a start. What sparked the riot?
Some of the prisoners refused to leave the dining room after lunch.
Lunch? But Jackson was stabbed at 4 p.m. Was his wife held captive all that time?
Yes.
Well, did you make any attempt to get her out, call in outside help?
No.
Why not?
Oh, well, you know what it's like, Jack. The slightest whisper of a riot and the press are onto it. Public opinion is pretty sensitive at the moment. I didn't want any publicity. Besides, I didn't think she was in any danger. It was a personal feud between two of the women. There are tensions like that in any prison. I had no reason to believe Meg was going to come to any harm. I didn't know it was going to end like that.
Yes, well, it's often difficult to know what's best to do in a situation like that. Well, perhaps we'll start by questioning these women. Who's this first one, Lynn Warner?
She first drew attention to the stabbing.
What's she in for?
Child kidnapping. You remember the Bentley case?
Oh, yeah, the kid's nanny. Could you have her brought in here?
You're not going to conduct the inquiries from here.
If you don't mind. It might make the murderer nervous to be in the dead man's room. That is, if it won't upset the widow too much.
No, we're not expecting her in today.
Don't let her get killed, Mum. You all right? Couldn't have got a wink of sleep last night. I heard you pacing up and down.
You couldn't have slept much either if you were listening to me.
Mum, I'm sorry. I didn't know what had happened when I walked in last night.
I know you couldn't have.
Don't shut me out, Mum.
I'm sorry. I just feel so empty. I can't believe it's happened. Then why would they want to kill him? He works so hard for them.
I know. I'm not going to school today.
No. No, I want you to go.
I won't leave you here on your own.
Will you do as you're told?
Thank you, Miss H. Could you wait outside, please? Sit down, Lynn. This is Detective Sergeant Allen. He wants to ask you a few questions about the murder of Mr. Jackson.
I've got nothing to say.
That attitude's not going to help you, young lady.
Why should I say anything? No one will believe me anyway. I'm innocent. No one believes me.
It'll go much better for you in the long run if you cooperate.
Will it affect my appeal?
Lynn is appealing against her sentence. She claims she is innocent.
I am innocent.
This inquiry has got nothing to do with your case.
Then I've nothing to say.
Do you want whoever did this to get away with it? Aren't you interested in seeing justice done?
Nobody else is.
Miss Warner, I don't think you realize how serious this is. It's an offense to hinder the police in their investigations. And you're a prime suspect in a murder case.
That's right. This is something else you can blame on me, is it?
Bring in the next one.
Miss Yates. Take her back to her cell.
Right.
Oh, by the way, Eddie Cook's outside. You said you wanted to see him when he arrived.
Right.
Come on.
Eddie?
Eddie Cook, the electrician. He was trapped in the prison during the riot.
With the rioters?
No, in another wing.
Well, let him wait. I want to talk to those directly concerned first.
The police will talk to you later.
Well, when?
When they're ready. Just wait there.
What are you doing here?
Well, I came to fix the wiring. I didn't get much chance yesterday. It's not funny, Marilyn. When I got here this morning, they told me that bloke was dead. Now the cops want to talk to me.
Why you?
Because I was there. Marilyn, I saw who did it.
You haven't told anyone, have you?
No, not yet.
Well, don't, Eddie.
Why not?
It'll be taken care of inside here.
Oh, I don't know, Marilyn. The cops might get nasty if I hold out on them.
They won't know who did it.
What's going on here? Didn't you two see enough of each other yesterday? Get back to work. I've already had a word to the governor about you.
Hello, are you looking for me? I'm running a bit late, I'm afraid. I stopped off at the hospital to see Rosie.
There's no rush. There'll be no sick call until the police have finished their inquiries. And they'll probably want a word with you later.
There's nothing I can tell them. Wish there was.
Perhaps you might know of one of the girls who had a grudge against him.
No. Any mail?
Karen Travers, for example.
What? I don't think she could have done it.
Why not?
Well, I just don't think she's the type, that's all.
Well, that's a strange thing to say. She's already stabbed her husband.
Oh, that was different. She had provocation. You saw the burns on her back.
Do you mean murder sometimes justified?
Look, if you're having a go at me, I don't see what's so damn funny about this whole matter. Meg, what are you doing here?
I'm on duty.
You look terrible. You should be at home resting.
Too much to do. We're short-staffed enough as it is. Somebody's got to look after the animals.
You're not being very cooperative, are you, Frieda?
Frankie.
Frankie. You realize that even if we can't prove that you stabbed him, there's still the possible charge of accessory to murder?
Oh, what? Now, look, I had nothing to do with it. All I wanted was to get even with B. Smith. I had nothing against Bill. He's not my type.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, well, it's obvious, isn't it? Why would any woman in here kill a bloke? Because you can't have him.
What are you talking about?
How should I know? Could be any one of them. Apart from the pommy doctor, Bill was the only bloke any of them ever saw.
I'll get it.
Well, you must have some idea who did it.
I've told you all I know.
Meg, we weren't expecting you in today.
I'm rostered on duty.
Detective Sergeant Allen, this is Meg Jackson.
Mrs. Jackson, I'm sorry about what's happened. I'm afraid so far we've not much to go on.
You're not likely to get much either. They'll all stick together.
They haven't had a chance to confer. They've all been locked in their dormitories during the investigation.
What difference does that make?
Yes, you're probably right. There's no point in disrupting the prison routine any further. This could take days. You can release them if you like.
Very well.
I'd like to speak to you, if I may, Mrs. Jackson.
Miss Yates, take Doyle back to solitary.
Come.
I'll get the other girls released. I'll be back later.
As far as we can ascertain, this is a list of all those directly involved in the riot, those that held you captive and had the opportunity to kill your husband. Are there any names you can add?
No.
Well, have you any idea which of them was responsible?
As far as I'm concerned, they all were.
Come on, out you come. What's going on?
You're going back to work.
But what about the police?
Don't worry, they'll get around to you. Although, if you ask me, they'll be wasting their time.
Of course. I don't know anything.
You wouldn't tell them if you did.
No. When I find out, they won't need the police to deal with it. And that goes for the rest of them that ganged up with Frankie against me.
Don't look at me. I was only having a bit of fun.
Yeah?
Well, now it's my turn.
Look, you lot are in enough trouble already, Smith. Don't make things any worse. Now get to work. Both of you! Get on with your work.
Well, you gonna stand there all day?
You can't be trusted on your own, can you?
All right, someone give me something to work on.
If found out anything yet.
No.
I know who did it.
Who? Did you see
him? No, not exactly. But before we went into lunch yesterday, she had a big row with Frankie. She picked up the scissors then. Doreen, you were there. You saw her.
Yeah. That's right.
Well, why would she want to stab Bill Jackson?
I don't know. Probably to cause trouble. You know what she's like. She killed her old man.
Yeah, well, some husbands deserve it.
What's going on?